Sierra Online's Mystery House was the company's first pioneering steps into the graphic adventure genre. It all began in a restaurant, a recently wed couple having steak and chips. Roberta Williams had just played Colossal Cave Adventure, the very first interactive text adventure, and wanted to make a similar game that had a little bit more disemboweling. Ken Williams, her husband and freelance programmer, was at the time working on a compiler for the Apple II. One day he'd brought home Colossal Cave. Roberta became addicted and convinced Ken to scrap his $1 million idea to make a text adventure, but with pictures. Her plan was a murder mystery game akin to Agatha Christie novels. Ken stopped making his programming language and began unpacking the impossible task of producing graphics for the Apple II. He knew that displaying one image on screen would require so many floppies, but Roberta had already drawn a rudimentary diagram on a napkin and was brandishing a steak knife, so he thought, better not risk it. Ken was a clever guy, so he bought an advanced Etch-a-Sketch called a VersaWriter and wrote some software that would allow images to be stored using a limited number of bytes. Rather than storing an image pixel by pixel, Ken's software only stored data for the vertices of a given shape. The result was monochrome graphics that were virtually indistinguishable from the real world.
I feel as if I were inside Hastings Manor.
My compliments, Michael, James, everyone.
Have I done something wrong?
Roberta placed her hand-drawn images into the VersaWriter, traced over them and pressed a button to mark the endpoints of each line. Ken, who for some reason was never nominated for Husband of the Year in 1980, produced a series of table and text-based utilities that allowed Roberta to make her game and compile it. Judging the game by today's standards would be unfair, but for the most part it's pretty clear what each object in the room is. Without colour, some objects such as the towel are a little more challenging to figure out. Is this a hammer? A brush? Without a detailed text description when you type look, you're mostly expected to know what you're looking at, but it isn't often a problem. There's no pixel hunting that would plague later adventure games, but where the graphics do interrupt gameplay is when you're expected to navigate from one scene to another and the next room is identical to the last. I got stuck a couple of times thinking I hadn't input the correct command and was still in the same doorway, only to realise I'd sidled east to an identical doorway. A simple description of the scene accompanies each area, but further information is never really that forthcoming. Since the game was released into the public domain in 1987, you're greeted with a message claiming that this is a great moment in history and a request for a donation to Roberta Williams' favourite charity. Okay. He also claims that I should not contact Sierra if I get stuck, but my local Apple users group might be able to help. Okay. You can jump straight into the fray or read the instructions. In-game instructions weren't exactly commonplace in 1980. Most of the time you'd need a manual to even know what the story was. Cannon fodder, for example, was made a decade later, and you only get a funny song in a video, and the manual is mostly jokes about sandwiches. Credit must go here to providing some context for the events of Mystery House.
Did you come
in? I'm not sure who we are and why we've just broken to this house, or even who these people are. Once you leave the room and come back, they're all gone anyway. You'll find notes that hint at the existence, but not the location of some treasure.
Who was it, Dr. Sullivan?
The choice treasures. Those treasures.
Without dialogue options, it would have been nice if these notes provided some clues, but they're just there. Navigating is an issue. The game uses a text parser that allows you to enter two-word commands, often using a verb and a noun. As you enter the house, you would assume that you're looking in the direction the character has entered from. This isn't the case. The camera positioning, for want of a better description, changes angle and direction. This is the front door we came through, but the camera is pointing the opposite way. Sometimes the game expects you to input cardinal directions, but other points, north, south, east and west, won't get you anywhere. It can be somewhat tricky to figure out that you need to go steps to get into the house, for example. I got completely lost in these woods and ended up in some kind of an infinite loop. Interacting with objects can be a bit of a guessing game too. How do I turn the tap on? Turn tap, tap on, water on. There we go. This is particularly annoying when your character decides to set themselves on fire and you very quickly need to pour water. I mean, it seems obvious, but I just don't cope well under that kind of pressure. In reality, if you can just figure out how to get around, the puzzles actually aren't too difficult. You find dead bodies, but they don't provide any clues. At this point, the game is just like any later adventure game. find an object and use the object in the correct place. I did get stuck at one point. I'd acquired a hammer, but I tried bashing everything and nothing was for breaking. Wait, hang on. Let's try my local Apple user group. So what about the sound? There we go. So is Mystery House worth playing today? Yes and no. If you're interested in the history of gaming, then yes. As a game, the movement mechanics are too frustrating and just ruin what is otherwise actually quite a fun adventure game.